Hello, I'm JD Hilberry. Now, most pencil artists start off with using graphite. The problem with graphite is that it is incapable of producing really dark values. It can only produce a very dark gray. It can't get very black blacks. And if you try to get very dark with it, it'll end up getting shiny. This reflectiveness that happens with graphite can totally ruin the realism you're trying to create in a drawing. Now, usually, if you're attempting to put in a really dark value, it means you're trying to represent an absence of light, something in a shadow or something like that. And the last thing that you want is a bunch of shiny graphite destroying that illusion. You don't want a bunch of reflections shining back in something that's supposed to represent an absence of light. What I do is use other pencils to try to compensate for that. Graphite has its place. It's very good for creating really nice, soft values, and I'm going to show you examples of that, and I'll show you places where you shouldn't be using graphite because it is hurting the realism in your drawing you're trying to create. On this drawing, the entire paper was toned very lightly with graphite, except in the area that looks like it's kind of bowed out on the paper. Graphite is great for extremely soft, smooth values like this. It's how I render the look of wrinkled paper in some of my other drawings. Charcoal, on the other hand, can produce extremely dark values, much darker than graphite. Charcoal pencils were used in this drawing for the values like the cast shadows of my hands and other dark areas of my face. If I would have used graphite in those dark areas, the graphite shine would have destroyed the realism. It also would have been impossible to get graphite as dark as this. Learning to know where, how, and why to use graphite, charcoal, and carbon pencils is the key and what this series of videos will teach you. I'll start by showing you a few of my favorite pencils and explain why and where I use them. And then towards the end of this video, I'll show you a drawing that's just done with graphite by itself, and then the same drawing done with charcoal that can really make it pop. A Kimberly 9XXB graphite. This goes in the graphite column because it's considered a graphite pencil. However, it has carbon in the mixture of clay and graphite. That addition of carbon makes it so it's not quite as reflective as many of the other graphite pencils. And now I'm going to push this pencil as dark as it will go. This is without any layering at all. Now I'm going to pick up the paper so you can see the graphite shine once it's tipped just a tiny bit. See, all of the graphites up there get a graphite shine. No matter how you layer them, the one on the bottom, 9XXB, doesn't happen. Along with that 9XXB, I want to show you the other pencils that I use to get very, very dark values that don't produce that shininess. This first one is a 2/8 extra hard charcoal pencil made by Generals again. Start off with a lighter value here, and next to it I'll do a darker value. I don't have to worry about layering this charcoal so much. You can get dark right away without getting that graphite shine. You can also get very sharp edges with this since it is so hard. I can just go over this with the charcoal and make a very nice clean edge. Now that's the hardest charcoal pencil I use. The next charcoal that I like to use, called a Primo HB, General's Pencil Company, and we'll see how dark we can get with it. If you need sharper lines, you can always go back in with the 2H extra hard and sharpen up some of the edges. The darkest charcoal I've ever found is called a Primo Elite Grande Organic Black 5000. And it's just as dark as its name is long. And with charcoal, as I said, you can totally obliterate the paper without any problem of reflection. Again, if I need sharper lines, go back in with the 2H extra hard to make very, very sharp lines. Now let me show you the difference between graphite and charcoal as far as that shininess goes. Notice on the charcoal on the right, we don't get any of that reflection. It can be very distracting and take away from the realism of your drawing. You also don't get it in that 9XXB on the bottom.
It doesn't matter what brand of graphite pencils you are using. The formula is mainly graphite and clay, like most major brands, the darkest values possible will have a graphite shine. This is true for all mechanical pencils as well.
Now I'd like to show you how this comes into play on a real drawing here. In this first example, I've drawn this picture of an eye here. This drawing is rendered in graphite, and the darkest areas are rendered in 6B, which on its own, looks like a pretty good drawing of an eye. It has some pretty dark values, some good contrast, but we can do better. You'll notice when I tip the paper a little bit, that graphite shine that I showed you in all those other examples can become very distracting. This is being lit from directly above me. The camera is pointed directly down at the paper here, and it's hard to get this even in a position to where we don't see that reflective shine of graphite. I hear artists sometimes say that you have to look at a picture directly from the side to ever get that distraction of the glare from graphite. Well, we're not looking at this from the side at all, and you can see how that happens. Graphite shine is dependent upon where the light source is. This is the picture plane here. This is dark graphite. This is the light source, light shining down on your drawing with graphite on it. And this is where you're looking at that drawing. And if this angle is the same from where the light source is to where you are looking at the drawing here, you're going to get graphite shine. It's totally dependent on where the light source is and the angle that you're looking at it. Now next to this, I've drawn the same eye here using a mixture of charcoal and graphite. The darkest values in this one, I've just used that 2H extra hard charcoal. I've used graphite for the smoother areas, and the white of the eye is in graphite because I want to show a difference in texture. And charcoal allows me to do that when combined with graphite. The other thing I'd like to point out is since that charcoal has allowed me to get such dark values that I'm able to show even more values in what appear to be lighter areas. For instance, the wetness of the eye, because I have a wider value range to work with. Now I'll show you these side by side. Now this looks a little strange because these are both right eyes here, but I just wanted to show you this glare of the graphite on the left when I pick up the paper just a tiny bit. It totally destroys that realistic look and is very distracting in my opinion. So you really have two choices. You can use graphite and not get as dark as you would like to. That will help avoid that shine. But when you do that, you won't have as much contrast. The other choice is to use pencils that don't cause that glare in the darker areas. Much of this drawing is done with the 2H extra hard charcoal because just by its very nature, it is much rougher, creates a rougher texture. And I can use that to my advantage to help with the realism here. There's also areas that are done in graphite where I want a smoother texture in there. Inside the white of the eye there, some other areas where light is hitting the face and not creating nearly as much texture, that can all be done in graphite as well. Let me zoom in a little bit so you can see the texture I create here, where it looks like you can even see the pores in the skin, which I'm going to show you in a later video. And this is actually fairly easy to do once you know the techniques and where you can apply charcoal, where you can apply graphite, using each of these pencils and various blending techniques to create more texture, more contrast. The thing I want you to learn from this demo is that no matter what brand of pencil you're using, if you're trying to get very dark values and you're getting a graphite shine, you're taking away from the realism that you're trying to achieve there. If you're avoiding using the softer pencils because you don't like that graphite shine, it means you're limiting your range of values, and that's taking away from the realism. So hopefully this little demonstration will help you learn how to get more realistic with your drawings. If you're interested in trying some of these pencils I've shown you here, click the link below and it'll take you to my website where you can order a pencil kit that contains the pencils I've shown you here that get the very, very dark values without the graphite shine. And sign up on my YouTube channel so you can see the next video in this series. Thanks for watching.